Hello everyone. My name is Pooja Bansal. I'm student of BPD third year. I'm going to present scapular region. This topic is for young physio oratorship contest. In this presentation, I will tell you guys about the muscles of scapular region, structures present under the cover of deltoid, intermuscular spaces, axillary nerve, and lastly, anastomosis around scapula. Firstly, I will tell you guys what is scapula. Scapula is a flat bone which is present in the posterior part of the upper thoracic region. It contains two surfaces, costal surface or anterior surface, dorsal surface or posterior surface. It has three processes. First is acromion process, which articulates with the clavicle to form the acromioclavicular joint. Second is coracoid process. Third and last is the spinous process. This spinous process divides the dorsal surface of the scapula into two parts, upper small part and lower bigger part. This upper small part contains the supraspinous fossa and this lower part contains the infraspinous fossa. Then it contains three angles. First is lateral angle, modified to form the glenoid cavity. This glenoid cavity articulates with the head of humerus to form the glenohumeral joint. Second angle is the superior angle. Third angle is the inferior angle. Scapula has three borders, lateral border, superior border, and medial border. This is how scapula looks anteriorly, this is laterally, and this is posteriorly. This is the costal surface. This costal surface also contains a fossa, which is known as subscapular fossa. Now, this is the superior border. This is supraspinous fossa. This is infraspinous fossa. This is medial border. This is lateral border. And this is the glenoid cavity, acromion process, coracoid process, and lastly, spinous process. Now, what are the muscles which come in scapular region? First, supraspinatus. Second, infraspinatus. Third, teres minor. Fourth, teres major. Fifth, subscapularis. Sixth and last is deltoid. I will start with supraspinatus. Origin, medial two-third of the supraspinous fossa of the scapula. Insertion, upper impression on the greater tubercle of humerus. Nerve supply, suprascapular nerve. Having root value C5 to C6, suprascapular nerve is the branch of the upper trunk of brachial plexus. Action, initiation of abduction from 0 to 15 degree. Supraspinatus muscle looks like this. It originates from the scapula and gets inserted onto the greater tubercle of humerus. Second muscle is the infraspinatus muscle. Origin, it originates from the medial two-thirds of the infraspinous fossa of scapula. Insertion, middle impression on the greater tubercle of humerus. Nerve supply is same as supraspinatus, suprascapular nerve, having root value C5 and C6 and is the branch of the upper trunk of brachial plexus. Action is the lateral rotation of arm. Infraspinatus muscle looks like this, originating from scapula and getting inserted onto the greater tubercle of humerus. Third muscle is the teres minor muscle. Origin, upper two-thirds of the dorsal surface of lateral border of scapula as two slips. Teres minor originates in two slips because there is one artery which passes from the teres minor. That artery is circumflex scapular artery. Circumflex scapular artery is the branch of subscapular artery. And this subscapular artery is the branch of third part of axillary artery. Now insertion, teres minor gets inserted onto the lowest impression on the greater tubercle of humerus. Nerve supply by the axillary nerve having root value C5 and C6. Axillary nerve is the small terminal branch of the posterior cord of brachial plexus, about which I will be talking in detail later. Now, action of teres minor is lateral rotation of arm. Teres minor muscle looks like this. So, on greater tubercle of humerus, there is insertion of three muscles. First is supraspinatus, second is infraspinatus, third is teres minor. And action of teres minor and infraspinatus is same, that is the lateral rotation of arm. Fourth muscle is teres major muscle. ओरिजिन लोअर वन थर्ड ऑफ द डॉर्सल सर्फेस ऑफ लेटरल बॉर्डर एंड इन्फीरियर एंगल ऑफ स्कैपुला इंसर्शन ऑन टू द मीडियल लिप ऑफ द बाइसिपिटल ग्रूव ऑफ ह्यूमरस नर्व सप्लाई लोअर सबस्कैपुलर नर्व हैविंग रूट वैल्यू C5 एंड C6 लोअर सबस्कैपुलर नर्व इज द ब्रांच ऑफ द पोस्टीरियर कॉर्ड ऑफ ब्रेकियल प्लेक्सस एक्शन ऑफ टीरियस मेजर मसल इज द मीडियल रोटेशन एंड एडक्शन ऑफ आर्म टीरियस मेजर मसल लुक्स लाइक दिस originating from the lower lateral border and from the inferior angle of scapula and getting inserted onto the medial lip of intertubercular sulcus of humerus. Fifth muscle is subscapularis. This muscle is a multipinnate muscle. Origin from the medial two-third of the subscapular fossa. Insertion, lesser tubercle of humerus, nerve supply, upper and lower subscapular nerve having root value C5 and C6. Both upper and lower subscapular nerve are the branches of the posterior cord of brachial plexus. Action, medial rotation and adduction of arm. Teres major and subscapularis both have same action, medial rotation and adduction of arm. Subscapularis muscle looks like this. It originates from the costal surface of scapula and gets inserted onto the humerus. So, out of all the five muscles, first four muscles, supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor and teres major originates from the dorsal part of the scapula and gets inserted onto the humerus, whereas subscapularis originates from the costal part of scapula and gets inserted onto the humerus. All the nerves supplying these five muscles have root value from C5 to C6. Now, last muscle is deltoid muscle. Deltoid muscle is a very big muscle of the scapular region. Origin, deltoid muscle gets originated into three types of fibers, anterior fibers, middle or multipinnate fibers, and posterior fibers. Anterior fiber originates from the anterior border and the adjoining surface of the lateral one-third of clavicle. Then middle or multipinnate fibers originate from the lateral border of acromion process of scapula where four septa of origin are attached. Now posterior fibers originate from the lower lip of the crest of spine of scapula. So deltoid originates from the clavicle and scapula and gets inserted onto the humerus. Insertion is where deltoid tuberosity of humerus. Nerve supply of deltoid, axillary nerve having root value C5 and C6. What is the action of deltoid? All the three fibers of deltoid have different actions. Multipinnate or middle fibers are also known as acromial fibers. They are the abductors of arm from 15 to 90 degrees. From 0 to 15 degrees, supraspinatus was doing the abduction, whereas deltoid does the abduction from 15 to 90 degrees. Now, secondly, anterior fibers. Anterior fibers are responsible for the flexion and medial rotation of arm. Posterior fibers are responsible for extension and lateral rotation of arm. This is the anterior deltoid originating from the clavicle, middle deltoid which originates from the acromion process, and posterior deltoid which originates from the crest of spine of scapula. Now I will tell you in brief and revise the action of all the muscles. Firstly, for abduction of arm, two muscles are responsible. From 0 to 15 degrees, supraspinatus muscle, and from 15 to 90 degrees, middle or multipinnate or acromial fibers of deltoid. Second action is adduction of arm. For adduction of arm, also two muscles are responsible, subscapularis muscle and teres major muscle. Third action, external, also known as lateral rotation. For lateral rotation, three muscles are responsible, infraspinatus, teres minor, and posterior fibers of deltoid. Fourth action, internal rotation or medial rotation. Three muscle fibers are responsible, anterior fibers of deltoid, subscapularis muscle, and teres major muscle. Now for flexion, anterior fibers of deltoid are responsible. For extension, posterior fibers of deltoid are responsible. Now, what are the structures which are present under the cover of deltoid? As I told you, deltoid is a very big muscle, so it contains many structures beneath it. Bones, nerves, vessels, muscles, and joints and ligaments, and lastly, bursae. Now, which bones are present under deltoid? First is upper end of humerus. Second is coracoid process of scapula. This is a coracoid process of scapula. Upper end of humerus contains head of humerus, anatomical neck, morphological neck, surgical neck, intertubercular sulcus, lesser tubercle, greater tubercle. Now muscles. Muscles, insertion of which muscles occur under deltoid cover? First is pectoralis minor on the coracoid process of scapula. This is pectoralis minor getting inserted on coracoid process of scapula. Then secondly, supraspinatus, infraspinatus and teres minor on the greater tubercle of humerus. Supraspinatus muscle, then infraspinatus muscle and teres minor getting inserted on greater tubercle of humerus. Third, subscapularis on lesser tubercle of humerus. This is subscapularis getting inserted on lesser tubercle of humerus. Then lastly, pectoralis major on lateral lip of intertubercular sulcus, teres major on medial lip of intertubercular sulcus and latissimus dorsi on the floor of intertubercular sulcus. This is teres major, latissimus dorsi and pectoralis major. So overall, 8 muscles gets inserted under the cover of deltoid. Now, origin of which muscles occur? First is coracobrachialis and short head of biceps brachii from the coracoid process of scapula. This is the short head of biceps brachii. This is the coracobrachialis muscle originating from coracoid process. Secondly, long head of biceps brachii from the supraglenoid tubercle of scapula. In the glenoid cavity of scapula, there are 2 tubercles, one present above glenoid cavity, one present below glenoid cavity. The tubercle which is present above is known as supraglenoid tubercle. Tubercle which is present below is known as infraglenoid tubercle. Supraglenoid tubercle is giving origin to long head of biceps brachii, whereas infraglenoid tubercle is giving origin to long head of triceps brachii. Now, lateral head of triceps brachii originates from the upper part of posterior surface of humerus. So, 5 muscles originate under the cover of deltoid. Vessels, 2 vessels, anterior circumflex humeral vessel and posterior circumflex humeral vessels. These contains both artery and veins. Anterior circumflex humeral artery originates from the third part of axillary artery and posterior circumflex humeral artery also originates from the third part of axillary artery. Now, which nerve is present below deltoid? Axillary nerve. Axillary nerve has root value C5 and C6 and it is the branch of the posterior cord of brachial plexus. So, next, joints and ligaments. Musculotendinous cuff of shoulder. Musculotendinous cuff of shoulder is also known as rotator cuff. This rotator cuff is formed by the 4 muscles. Mnemonic for these 4 muscles is SITS. S stands for supraspinatus, I stands for infraspinatus, T stands for teres minor and S stands for subscapularis. Supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor originates from the dorsal surface of scapula and gets inserted onto the greater tubercle of humerus, whereas subscapularis originates from the costal surface of scapula and gets inserted onto the lesser tubercle of humerus. Secondly, there is coracoacromial ligament. This coracoacromial ligament is ligament present between coracoid process and acromion process of scapula. Here we can see the rotator cuff muscles in anterior view and posterior view. Now bursa, which is present under deltoid, subacromial bursa or subdeltoid bursa. This bursa is named as follows because it is present below the acromion process and present below the deltoid muscle. This is the largest bursa of our body. Subacromial bursa looks like this. This is the acromion process and over here would be the deltoid muscle. Now, these were the structures which are present under deltoid. Now, we will talk about the clinical anatomy. First is intramuscular injections are often given to the deltoid muscle. Whenever we want to give the intramuscular injection in the upper limb, deltoid muscle would be the first and foremost choice. Second, tendon of supraspinatus may undergo degeneration. This can give rise to calcification and even spontaneous rupture of the tendon. So, supraspinatus muscle tendon is prone to degeneration and this degeneration will result in calcification or the rupture of this tendon. Third is the subacromial bursitis. Subacromial bursitis is the inflammation of the subacromial or the subdeltoid bursa. Pressure over the deltoid below the acromion process whenever arm is by the side will result in pain. So if the patient comes when his arm is by the side and he's feeling pressure over the deltoid below acromion process, this will result in pain. However, when the arm is abducted, pressure over the same point causes no pain because the bursa disappears under the acromion process. If we ask the patient to abduct his or her arm and this same pressure results in no pain, then this means that bursa disappears under the acromion process. This is known as Dobbin sign. We can use this Dobbin sign to determine whether the patient or person is suffering from subacromial bursitis or not. Now we have completed the muscles of scapular region, structures under the cover of deltoid. Now intermuscular spaces. Intermuscular spaces are present between the humerus bone and the scapula bone, and as the name suggests, these are formed by the muscles. Muscle forming these spaces are teres minor, teres major, and lastly long head of trapezius brachii. There are three intermuscular spaces, and these spaces are named on the basis of their shapes. In the upper part, quadrangular space is present laterally and upper triangular space is present medially. In the lower part, there is lower triangular space. This is the quadrangular space, this is upper triangular space, and this is the lower triangular space. Now we will talk about each space. First is quadrangular space. Boundaries, it has four boundaries: superior, inferior, medial, and lateral. Superior boundary formed by the inferior border of teres minor behind and subscapularis in front. Inferior boundary by the superior border of teres major muscle. Medial boundary by the lateral border of long head of trapezius brachii muscle. And lateral boundary by the surgical neck of humerus. What are the contents of quadrangular space? Axillary nerve and posterior circumflex humeral vessels. This is quadrangular space. Teres minor forming the superior boundary. Then teres major forming the inferior boundary, surgical neck of humerus forming the lateral boundary, and long head of trapezius brachii forming the medial boundary. It contains axillary nerve, this is the axillary nerve, and this is the posterior circumflex humeral vessels. Second space is upper triangular space. It has three boundaries: superior, lateral, inferior. Superior boundary is formed by the inferior border of teres minor, lateral boundary is formed by the medial border of long head of trapezius brachii, and inferior boundary is formed by the superior border of teres major muscle. What is the content of upper triangular space? Circumflex scapular artery. As I told you before, circumflex scapular artery is a branch of subscapular artery, and this subscapular artery arises from the third part of axillary artery. This is the circumflex scapular artery. This is upper triangular space. Teres minor forming the superior boundary. Teres major forming the inferior boundary. And long head of trapezius brachii forming the lateral boundary. Third and last space is the lower triangular space. It also has three boundaries: medial, lateral, superior. Medial boundary is formed by the lateral border of long head of trapezius brachii. Lateral boundary is formed by medial border of humerus. Superior boundary formed by the lower border of teres major muscle. What are the contents? Radial nerve and profunda brachii vessels. Radial nerve is the branch of the posterior cord of the brachial plexus. Profunda brachii artery is the branch of the brachial artery. This is how lower triangular space looks like. This is the teres major muscle forming the superior boundary. This is the long head of trapezius brachii forming the medial boundary, and this is the humerus forming the lateral boundary, and this is the post profunda brachii artery, and this is the radial nerve. Now, axillary nerve. Axillary nerve is called axillary as it runs through the upper part of axilla, though it does not supply any structure over there. It is also called circumflex as it courses around the surgical neck of humerus to supply the prominent deltoid muscle. Axillary nerve has two names, axillary and circumflex. Axillary because it runs through axilla, circumflex because it winds around the surgical neck of humerus. Root value of axillary nerve is ventral rami of C5 and C segments of spinal cord. Course of axillary nerve. Axillary nerve begins in the axilla. It is the smaller terminal branch of posterior cord of brachial plexus. Then it runs backwards through the quadrangular space. In quadrangular space, it lies below the capsule of shoulder joint. Lastly, it winds around the surgical neck of humerus, where it divides into two divisions, anterior and posterior division. What are the branches of axillary nerve? Trunk of axillary nerve gives articular branch to the shoulder joint. Then anterior division of axillary nerve gives one branch, that is muscular branch, to most part of deltoid. Last is the posterior division. Posterior division gives three branches. First is the muscular branch given to the posterior part of deltoid and to the teres minor muscle. The nerve to teres minor is characterized by the presence of pseudoganglion. Second branch is upper lateral cutaneous nerve of arm, which supplies the skin over the lower half of deltoid. Last branch is the vascular branch, which is provided to the posterior circumflex humeral artery. This is the axillary nerve. It gives the anterior terminal division, which is supplying the most of the part of deltoid. This is the posterior terminal division, which is supplying the teres minor muscle and supplying the posterior part of deltoid. Then it continues as the upper lateral cutaneous nerve of arm. Now, clinical anatomy of axillary nerve. Axillary nerve may be damaged by the dislocation of shoulder joint or by the fracture of surgical neck of humerus. There is a cause of axillary nerve gets damaged whenever we have dislocation of shoulder joint or whenever there is fracture of the surgical neck of humerus. Now, what is the effect of this damage to axillary nerve? First is the rounded contour of shoulder joint is lost. Greater tubercle of humerus becomes prominent. Deltoid muscle is the muscle which is responsible for forming the rounded contour of our shoulder joint. So, damage to axillary nerve will result in paralysis of deltoid muscle. Paralysis of deltoid muscle will result in loss of rounded contour and the greater tubercle of our humerus becomes prominent. Second point, as I told you, deltoid is paralyzed, so there will be loss of abduction up to 90 degree. Last, there is sensory loss over the lower half of deltoid in a badge-like area called regimental badge. As I told you, posterior division gives one cutaneous branch that is known as upper lateral cutaneous nerve of arm. This upper lateral cutaneous nerve of arm is what responsible for supplying the skin over the lower half of deltoid. So whenever there is damage to axillary nerve, there is sensory loss over the lower half of deltoid. Now, clinical anatomy of axillary nerve is finished. This is the regimental area which I was talking about. There is loss of sensation. Then, as I told you, there is loss of rounded contour. Deltoid muscle is paralyzed or atrophy. And the greater tubercle of humerus has become prominent. Now, last topic, anastomosis. Anastomosis in scapula occurs in two parts. Anastomosis around the body of scapula. Second is anastomosis over the acromion process of scapula. Anastomosis around body of scapula occurs in three fossa, subscapular fossa in costal surface and supraspinous and infraspinous fossa on dorsal surface. It is formed by the three arteries. First is suprascapular artery, branch of the first part of subclavian artery. Second is deep branch of transverse cervical artery, which is the branch of first part of subclavian artery. And last is circumflex scapular artery, branch of the subscapular artery, which arises from the third part of axillary artery. So there is a small note. This anastomosis occurs between the first part of subclavian artery and third part of axillary artery. Second anastomosis over the acromion process. It also contains three arteries. First is the acromial branch of thoracoacromial artery. This thoracoacromial artery is the branch of the second part of axillary artery. Second is acromial branch of suprascapular artery. This suprascapular artery is the branch of first part of subclavian artery. Third is the acromial branch of posterior circumflex humeral artery. This posterior circumflex humeral artery is again the branch of the third part of axillary artery. There is a small note in this anastomosis also. Anastomosis between first part of subclavian artery and branches of second and third part of axillary artery. This is where anastomosis occur in the infraspinous fossa. For supraspinous fossa, anastomosis occur here. And acromion process anastomosis occurs here. Now, all the data for this presentation has been taken from the human anatomy of upper limb and thorax by the B.D. Chaurasia. And thank you so much for listening to my presentation. Thank you so much, Regional Academy, for giving this opportunity to me. And thank you so much, Dr. Nitin Kumar Arora and Nishant Arora, for always listening to my doubts and helping me throughout this process. Thank you.